King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table by Benedict Flynn. Sea wolves, the people call them, stealing across the grey waves in their dragon ships to Britain. At first they came to burn and pillage, to strike cruel and quick, load up with plunder, then hurry for the dragon ships and the sea road home. But soon they grew hungry for more than loot. Then they began to settle on the land, and the country was never long at peace. The Britons were pushed west to Cornwall, to Wales. Then came one Briton called Uther Pendragon. He roused his people against the Saxon raiders and their allies. No other king was brave enough. The invaders were halted. Peace came to the western lands. As long as Uther Pendragon lasted, peace would last. But now Uther Pendragon was dying. The years of fighting had sapped his strength. Who would succeed him? He had no heir. His only child with Queen Igraine died a baby. A fever, some said. His knights already quarreled over who should rule next. Evil days lay ahead. Warlord fighting against robber baron, dangerous days of strife and misery. And all the while, the Saxons and their allies would be harrying, pressing, taking a village here, a fort there, never resting. It is midnight. In the great fortress of Castle Camelot, an old man slips unannounced into the king's bedchamber. Beneath the furs that cover him, Uther Pendragon is weakening fast. He has not moved or spoken for hours now. His breathing is ragged, his lips the colour of clay. "Pendragon," says the old man. He takes the king's hand. His own is traced by strange tattoos.
"Merlin, is he safe? I must know. They must not discover him."
The old man nods. Uther Pendragon's eyes half close in relief. For a while he seems to sleep. When he wakes, his voice is fainter than a whisper.
"Tell him, Merlin, when the time comes, won't you? Tell him it was the only way."
Uther Pendragon's hand falls to the bed. Suddenly there is a noise, a rush of cold air. Two knights appear in the doorway. Their swords are unsheathed and their breath comes in gasps. They have been searching for this old man. A woman enters. Her hair is wild and black and long. She is far more menacing than the knights.
"Too late, Morgana le FayÕs," says the old man. "Your magic has failed you this time. The Pendragon can tell you nothing now."
"My magic is not so dull, Merlin," she hisses at him. "I know about the child."
The air is crackling with their hate.
"But you shall not find him, Morgana. I have seen to that. He will live to defeat you yet." "But you will not live, Merlin."
The knights lift their swords. But the death blow never comes. The old man simply twitches a finger and the swords clatter to the floor.
"Inform the queen," he says as he sweeps into the corridor and past the king's bodyguard. They are frozen with surprise and fear. "The king is dead."
"Ghosts and beasts, unnatural in this forest. Be on your guard," said a voice.
"Vagabonds and thieving types too. Watch for them," said another. "Just our luck if we're ambushed taking a message to Sir Ector," said a third.
Not very impressive, thought Arthur. The voices belonged to three soldiers just below him. He was lying along the spreading branches of an old beech.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.